Should have coast clear.
Boy, if you don't get.
Oh shit, we live? We live? Oh shit. Oh damn. Weezy out of here.
The riches from rags. I just believe in myself and somehow I made it out the block. I hit the road.
Alright, what's up y'all? I'm back with another video. Sorry for the way. I know it's been a minute since I dropped anything, but reason being because YouTube's been blocking every single video that I've been trying to upload, you know what I'm saying, for Vlogmas due to copyright claims. So I kind of gave up and, you know, said forget it. But here I'm back, you feel me? So today I'll be giving tips on how to grow your social media platforms, specifically Instagram as well as YouTube. So so we can just hop straight into it. Tip number one, be active. So what that means is like and comment and share other people's posts. Like, being active is just one thing, you know what I'm saying? Like posting, yeah, that's cool, whatever, like posting daily or, you know, maybe once or twice a day or whatever, but actually be active. Like, use Instagram for what it's for. Like, comment on people's content, you feel me? Follow people that interest you, you feel me? For instance, if you have a business or whatever, follow other business, local businesses, interact with them. Like, you know, DM, network, you know? Like, people don't bite, we all human. You know, don't ever be afraid to just, you know, DM somebody, whether you may be close with them or maybe you just know them through social media. I do it all the time. So, shout outs. You know, do shout out for shout outs on your page, on your story, you know what I'm saying? Shout people out. Get close, you know, get close with people, build relationships with people, you know? Like I said, people don't bite. I mean, just make build relationships. Basically, that's key. Build relationships with people that you follow. That way, it's like you got a better chance of earning that person's support. So if you build relationships with your followers, they're more likely going to support you based off the relationship that you have with them. Tip number two, advertise and promote daily. So what I mean by that is use other social media platforms. If you got Facebook, you got Snapchat, you got Twitter, or even YouTube, they have links, copy and paste links, share those links to Facebook with your Facebook friends, Twitter followers, Snapchat followers. You can inbox people, text, you know, it's so many forms of promotion. So take advantage of every form of promotion there is. So promote, DM people your content. Yeah, just basically advertise, you know. Oh, TikTok's another one, TikTok. And make sure you're doing that like often, daily, until you notice that your followers are getting bigger and bigger. So you promote. Eventually, somebody's gonna see your content. The more you advertise and promote, the better chance that your followers will grow. Tip number three, word of mouth. Yes, word of mouth, that is very helpful. I don't care how much you think that it's not, it's very helpful. So let's say, for instance, like if you're an outgoing person, you know, if you go to a lot of parties, events, or if you just got a lot of friends, just go out and meet people, like strangers, complete strangers. Like, I guarantee you, go out, if you're friendly, especially if you're friendly, go out and meet other friendly people. There's so many forms of networking outside of social media. Co-workers, you have classmates, you have friends, roommates, strangers, people that you might see just walking down the street one day. You know, get kind of cool with people. Like, you don't got to get close, but like, it's very important to build relationships with people in general. Take advantage of everybody, like everybody that come across you, and take advantage of everybody that you come across throughout your life. You never know how beneficial somebody can be, you know. So, word of mouth, you know. You go to a party, you know, you meet people, you know, you meet artists or you meet a photographer, da 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 da. Talk to them, network. Hey, follow me on here. Follow me on there. I do this. Hey, check me out, you know. It's that easy.
Why are you making it complicated? It's easy.
Word of mouth, word of mouth, word of mouth. Go to these parties. It's about 300-400 people. You know, try to be seen. The more you go out, then the more noticed that you will be. Think about it. If you go to every event, and let's say other people, there's other people that go to these other events, like the people that go to the same events that you go to, like, they're going to notice you. They're going to notice that you're always at the event that they're always at. One day, they might just see you on Instagram or something, or on Facebook, like, oh, that's him that's be always at these parties. Like, you know, just try to be seen, because that helps. That helps go to everything. Like, you don't even, like, you don't have to go to everything. I'm not telling people to, like, I mean, enjoy yourself. It's like, it's enjoy yourself. Like, but you wants to be seen, want to be noticed if you want to build your following. Hey, I do this, I do that. Tell your coworkers, yeah, I do this. I sing, I rap, I do poetry. Follow me on Twitter, da 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 da. Check me out. Boom. Word of mouth. The more familiar people are with you, the closer they'll maybe become with you, the higher the chances that people will want to follow you or want to get to know more about you or want to. Tip number four, know your audience. That is important, very important. Make content based off what your audience like. Let me reword it. Make content based off what you know your followers like. So, prime example, I'm a dancer, right? And I have majority of dance followers. So, I know that all my followers follow dancers. So, they're interested in people that dance and make dance content. So, all I do is make dance videos. Also, I have non-dancers that's interested in dancers or any kind, any form of creativity and art. So, I know what to give my followers. I know what kind of content to make. I know what kind of content to create. So, it's easier for me to come up with ideas or video ideas, and you know, I don't have to try as hard because I know what my followers like. I know what kind of videos to make. I know what kind of dances or dance style that I can do that will attract my followers. So, bottom line, know your audience. Know what your audience like. Don't just post anything because not everybody's gonna like everything or any and everything that you post, because it's just not how it works. You gotta know your followers. Like, you gotta know your audience, you gotta know your followers, you gotta know what to post. And be creative, entertain, have fun. Most of all, just have fun. Make people interested in what you do. Bring your content to life. You have to be in control of your content. You have to be in control of your audience. You have to bring people to you. You want to make it like, oh, I like what he does. I'm going to follow him and I'm going to keep up with all his content. I follow him. I like it. He interests me. Da, 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 da. So, yeah. Also, tip number five, follow trends. Like, I mean, there's nothing wrong with following trends nowadays. Everything is a trend nowadays. I don't care how much you think it's not true. Everything is a trend, from fashion to hairstyles to music to dances to social media is trends. Like, social media is trends, movies, everything in life is a trend. So follow trends, use hashtags, positive trends, not the negative ones. Trends that can change your life. So dances, TikTok dances, fashion styles, you know, follow trends, like, you know, because people, like, do what's popping, do what everybody is doing, because 9 times out of 10, everybody that's doing it is doing it because of the trend. It's trending, so everybody hops on the way. Oh, I'm gonna do this because so-and-so this, or so-and-so that. I'm gonna do this because it's popping. I'm gonna wear this hairstyle because it's popping. I'm gonna wear these kind of clothes because it's popping. I'm gonna dress like this because it's popping. I'm gonna wear these type of shoes because it's popping, it's popular. You know, do popular shit that's gonna attract the people that follow these trends to you. That way you'll become a part of that particular community when you follow that particular trend. See, do it make sense? Makes sense. So yeah, follow those trends. Like, whatever trend interests you, hop on that wave. Like, there's nothing wrong with following a trend. And you can also be a trendsetter while following trends. I know a lot of people that follow trends, but also became a trendsetter later on, or vice versa. So you can also trendset, you know, come up with something catchy, come up with something that that you feel like people is gonna, you know, rock with or something, or, you know, come up with something. And you can even take a little bit of something from a trend and kind of switch it around and kind of make it your own. And then, you know, trendset. It's many ways to trendset. Easier to follow a trend than to trendset, because the trendset, you're in competition with your trendsetter. Now you gotta focus on worrying about who did it first or where did it come from versus actually just following that trend. So, alright, so now I'm about to get into growing your YouTube channel specifically for YouTube, and I'm gonna tell you the key factors that matters. So, your channel banners, your intros, your thumbnails for your videos, outros, and video descriptions, what else? Those are all the key factors that matters into growing your YouTube channel and gaining subscribers. So, when you have a channel banner that makes people take you serious, for starters, as a YouTuber. So, when somebody go to your YouTube channel and they see that you have a YouTube banner, like a customized banner, like with your photo and your social media platforms and everything, they're gonna take you more serious as a YouTuber. So now they're gonna be looking forward into your content or whatever. So that's just a start. So when you're becoming a YouTuber, make sure that's like the first step, your channel banner. Like, I wouldn't even say, don't even worry about your bio. Just, you know, get your YouTube banner. That's the first step. Second step, your intro. So your intro, that's gonna be your introduction to all your videos. All your videos. And you wanna make it as creative as possible, entertaining as possible. I'd say a range from about 15 to 20 seconds. But that's gonna be the intro to all your videos. So that's step number two. With the intro, that's kind of gonna get people more and more tuned in with, you know, your content and everything, and they're gonna be kind of looking forward into more and more and more. It's like that introduces your video. It basically represents your channel and kind of give your subscribers an idea of what your content and what your channel is gonna focus on. Your thumbnails, your custom thumbnails. It shows how much time and effort you put into creating your content. And with that, people are gonna see that you're taking your craft serious, and they're gonna make people want to, you know, subscribe to you because they see your work. Even if, let's say, you paid a graphic designer to do, you know, to do your YouTube graphics or whatever, that's still investing. So either way, you're either investing in your craft or you're taking time to work on your content or whatever. Either way, it's still effort and it's still a reason for people to take you serious because they see that you're really serious about being a YouTube. So, yeah, custom thumbnails where people see that you have great work on your channel. That's another reason for somebody to subscribe to you. So, the editing, that's kind of like, the editing is what makes your video. The great intro and nice video editing is what makes your video. So, if you have those two in every video that you post, you're guaranteed gaining some subscribers every video. With everything else, just like I was saying, like with Instagram, advertise, promote your video, word of mouth, you know, same thing. But YouTube is a little bit different because it's more focused on creating than just actually uploading and posting. As if with Instagram, it's like you're just posting and like you don't have to really, you know, do too much creating or take as much time. Instagram is kind of much more like a faster process. All you do is just post, take a picture, a video, make videos or whatever, and you post them. But YouTube, it's like you have to actually take time before you upload. Recording a YouTube video takes time already. So, it's like everything with YouTube is more so of creating. Whether you're doing it yourself or you're paying someone to do it for you. But YouTube is a lot more effort than Instagram. So, yeah, so think that'll kind of conclude YouTube tutorial, but this was helpful. Leave a thumbs up, feel free to leave a comment. Also be sure to hit that subscribe button. I got more content coming soon, so stay tuned.